Hi everyone, this is Shivani here. Welcome to my channel Shivani Creations. Today I am showing you how to create this super gorgeous money envelope or shagun envelope using handmade vellum flowers. So can you see these lovely flowers? These are completely handmade, hand shaped and hand colored. And from back side it is looking like this. You can just open the satin ribbon or satin thread, and inside this you can put the bunch of notes. So this is envelope for the gaddi shagun, and let's get started. For this I'm taking this sheet which measures 12 by 9 inches, and from left side I have creased on 1/2 inches, 4 inches, 4.5 inch, 8 inch and 8.5 inches. Now rotate the sheet, and from left side I have creased on 1/2 inches, 1 inches, 8 inch and 8.5 inch. Now fold all the creases first. This is the pattern paper sheet by Dress My Craft, and I have given all the supply links in description box if you want to purchase anything, but you can use any pattern paper of your choice. So this is done. Now I am going to cut some slits so that we can construct our box for envelope. So it should look like this. Now just fold all the parts, add glue and construct the box envelope. Hold it for some time and allow it to dry. So after drying, our envelope is ready and it will look like this. Now it's time to decorate it using handmade vellum flowers. So I am taking this sun-kissed flower by Heartfelt Creations, and I have the stamp set of this set. So I have already stuck it on my Misty stamp tool. And I'm taking this 180 GSM vellum paper, and I'm going to stamp the flowers on the vellum. So I'm just aligning the vellum according to my stamp set, and I'm securing the ends using the magnets. Now I'm using this VersaMark adhesive ink. This is an embossing ink pad, and I'm going to stamp the image of flowers and leaves on my vellum paper. Press it firmly and tightly and you will get the beautiful image. Right now maybe you can't see the image perfectly, but just a minute, I am going to pour some white embossing powder. So I'm just taking my funnel tray in the bottom and using Wow white embossing powder, I'm just sprinkling on the stamped image. And just remove the excess powder, and can you see the beautiful flowers? All the powder has been stuck to the stamped image. Now it's time to do the heat embossing. So I'm using my heat tool and embossing all the flowers and leaves, and it's looking absolutely gorgeous. Can you see the embossed and raised effect on the flowers? It's super opaque white, and now it's permanent. So now the white ink will not be removed. Now I have the matching die set by the Heartfelt Creation. So I'm just opening my die set. And I'm going to align it to my stamped image so that we can cut all the images at one go. So I will pass this through my die cut machine to cut the flowers and leaves. Okay, so align it properly and die cut it. So here I have die cut it, and just pop all the flowers and leaves from top, and see, in few seconds you have loads of flowers and leaves. So my base for the flower and leaves are ready. Now I will show you, if you don't have dies and stamp, what you can do. So I have the 6 petal vellum flower, and now to do the embossing effect of white color, I am taking my white gel pen by Bristro and I am doing the same pattern on the flower petal. I have given all the flower and leaf templates in description box. You just need to download it, print it and trace it on your vellum paper. So this is done and it is looking quite similar to my embossed flower. So on left side I have my embossed flower and on right side I have my pen flower. Both are looking quite similar. So after making the flower you can't find any difference. So it's perfectly alright. Now I will show you how to color these flowers. So the back side of my flower on which we didn't add any embossing powder, I am going to color it using my watercolor pencils. I am just giving some strokes using light pink shade, and in the center I will add olive green color. You can also use watercolor sketch pens or your Sharpie pens or watercolor sketch pens, anything which you have to color these. Now I am just spreading the color using some water since these are watercolor pencils, so color is spreading very nicely. And now to give little depth in the center, I am adding darker shade of pink only in the center part. And again I am spreading it using brush just to mix it with the light pink shade. And it will look like this from front. Now it's time to do some embossing. So I'm taking my paintbrush in the bottom and we just need to roll the petals on the brush like this, just like a pipe. So you will get the curved petal and it's super easy to do. My flower is little wet because I did little watercoloring. So if you used any copic marker or distress inks, so you have to wet the flower little bit using water mist. So in the same way I have embossed and colored the different sizes of flowers. Now I'm just arranging my whole flower by adding the layers. I'm just pinching in the center little bit after adding glue using ball tool so that all the layers will stick with each other properly. Now allow it to dry for some time. Till that time I will show you how to color the leaf. So I am adding little dark green color in the center and on the outer side I am adding olive green color. Again I am mixing it using water and doing the same embossing technique using paintbrush like we did with the flower petals. Like this. And now I have this small cute filler flower. I already done the coloring and embossing part and I'm just adding one wired pollen through this to create the filler flower. In the same way I have prepared some more filler flowers. Now our flower is completely dried, so I'm adding little glue in the center and sprinkling some pink color flower pearls in the center and adding little shimmer powder in the center to add little shine. In the same way I have created two more flowers and some more leaves. Now take back your envelope and on the base I am adding this beautiful pattern. I have used dye by iCraft to create this pattern. But if you don't have this, you can just skip this step. You can add any other pattern paper if you want. And then I'm adding the beautiful wavy border design here. This border die is again by iCraft. So just stick it like this. Cut the excess border. And now I'm adding one pink color satin thread in the center from front and back so that we can close our envelope. Like this. And then I will start arranging all my flowers, leaves and filler flowers. and here I have this beautiful sentiment, congratulations. So I'm adding the sentiment on upper corner. Then I have the beautiful scroll design in gold mirror cardstock. So I'm adding it in the bottom because I thought the bottom area is looking little empty. So all the decoration part is up to you, according to your requirement or according to your stash, you can decorate it in any way. And to hide this satin ribbon, I am just adding this beautiful border design on the back side. So this gorgeous vellum flower box envelope is ready, and I have created some loops using same satin ribbon cord to decorate it little more. Now you can just put the bunch of notes inside this for the gaddi envelope. So my project is done for today. Hope you enjoyed my video. Please subscribe my channel for more interesting videos, and please click on bell icon for the latest updates. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.